Distinguished Excellencies, Mayor of The Hague, distinguished delegates, ladies and gentlemen. It is an honor for me to open the Global Actions Ocean Summit for Food Security and Blue Growth in the beautiful city of The Hague in the Netherlands. For most of history, man has had to fight nature to survive. In this century, he is beginning to realize that, in order to survive, he must protect it. As Jacques-Yves Cousteau, one of the most important leaders for the ocean, said, "Do we dare, ladies and gentlemen? Do we dare to grow smarter today? Do we dare to fish smarter today? And do we dare to preserve our natural resources today, tomorrow, and in the future?" That's the 9 billion people question. Are we really willing to stop the moral outcry that still almost 1 billion people go hungry to bed every day? Are we willing to stop the over-exploitation of our natural resources, especially fish stocks? You, we, as global leaders, ocean practitioners, businesses, scientists, NGOs, civil society and international organizations have to find answers to these questions the coming days. This summit is about sharing experiences, but moreover, demonstrating how combined action in partnerships for healthier and productive oceans can drive sustainable growth and shared prosperity while preserving our natural resources for future generations. Let us be honest to each other. We know many of the answers to arrive at sustainable fisheries and to arrive at worldwide food security. Let's face the facts. 80% of all life on the planet is found in the oceans. The ocean provides a global life support system that helps regulate climate and supplies half of the planet's oxygen needed for one in every two breaths that we take. Of course, food security cannot be sustained without sustainable fisheries. Fish contributes 17% of the animal protein consumed by the world population and thus is a critical source of food, with demand expected to double in the next 20 years. Currently, 3 billion people depend on fish for 20% of their average per capita intake of animal protein. About 660 to 820 million livelihoods, or 10 to 12% of the world's population, are dependent on the fisheries. FAO reports show that 97% of the livelihoods that are directly dependent on fisheries and aquaculture occur in developing countries, mostly via small-scale operations in Asia. So healthy seas and oceans are key to rising our challenge. But three key threats to ocean health, overfishing, habitat change, and pollution, affect our ability to use the ocean to drive sustainable fishery, strong economies, and healthy communities. Actions to solve these threats have often been unsuccessful. Moreover, they have contributed to the tensions between growth and conservation, private sector interests, and equitable benefits for communities. Ladies and gentlemen, we need a new wave for the world. Fisheries and aquaculture generate considerable social and economic benefits for hundreds of millions of people around the world. These activities have the potential to increase their contribution to human well-being and growth. But these activities have also an inevitable impact on biodiversity and the environment. In 1992, in Rio, And in 2002 in Johannesburg, we agreed many goals, such as to implement the maximum sustainable yield approach for fisheries by 2015. We are not even close today. The good news is we are making progress. The bad news is if we don't step up our efforts, there is no fish left by 2030. The only way forward is bringing together stakeholders from across the public, private, civil society spheres to co-design solutions that can achieve healthy oceans at the speed and scale necessary to meet the challenges we face. Ladies and gentlemen, how do we turn the tide? First of all, we should go back to the basics. We should learn from concrete success stories where competing interests can be reconciled with a view to identifying actions, partnerships and financing that can help scale up activities that ultimately result in shared prosperity today and for future generations. Of course, governments have a key role in addressing the challenges, acting on their own and in concert with others. But fish has no boundaries. Regional cooperation is becoming even more important nowadays. More emphasis should be given through international cooperation and especially via, for example, regional fishery management organizations. Furthermore, partnerships agreements between the EU and other countries should include a much broader approach focusing not only on sustainable fisheries, but also on local communities and protected areas as well as habitats. For me, the crucial elements for sustainable fisheries are more selective fisheries methods, innovation, and a discard ban, which is workable and implementable for our fishermen. Innovations can really make a difference. In a tripartite cooperation between the fisheries sector, Wageningen University and Research Center, and the Netherlands government, we developed a much more selective fisheries method, the PulseCore. It is environmentally sound because it doesn't disturb our seabeds and uses half of the fuel. We are more than willing to share this innovative technique with you. Delegates, local communities are the key to implement sustainable growth and fisheries, promote changes across the entire production chain, and put fairness and the environment at its heart. Strong momentum exists to reshape the context in which the fisheries sector, independently of its scale, currently operates in order to ensure sustainable growth with equitable benefits for communities. Last but not least, we can significantly increase blue growth and global food fish production from both sustainable aquaculture and sustainable fisheries by adopting best practices and reducing environmental risk to stimulate investment. We can enable the world's overfished stocks to be rebuilt and increase the annual net benefits of captured fisheries by at least $20 billion, including through reducing subsidies that promote overfishing and by encouraging responsible governance of tenure. With these approaches and together, we need also to halve the current rate of natural habitat loss and reducing habitat degradation and fragmentation by applying ecosystem-based approaches to management, to increase marine protected areas and other affected area-based conservation measures, to include at least 10% of coastal and marine areas, and conserve and restore natural coastal habitats to reduce vulnerability and increase resilience to climate change impacts. We will therefore have to learn to build a more sustainable relationship with our oceans, because they are vital for food production, economic growth, and food security. We have to step up to our efforts. That is why the Netherlands, in cooperation with the World Bank, FAO, Indonesia, Grenada, the United States, and Norway, organizes this summit. Joint urgent action of the global community is needed to address the threats facing our oceans. Local successfully innovations should be identified and scaled up in all regions. Our joint ambition should be no less than identifying these and developing a strategic roadmap for actions. It takes generosity to discover the whole through others. If you realize you are only a violin, you can open yourself up to the world by playing your role in the concert, Jacques-Yves Cousteau said. I invite you all to join me in the new wave for the world. Thank you.